In this video, we're going to take a look at the new Inkscape 1.3 with improved performance, several new features, and a solid set of improvements to a few existing ones. The Inkscape team has focused on helping users get organized and work more efficiently. We're not going to cover everything, I'm just going to highlight some of the highly anticipated features. I'm going to show you guys the first one, which is the Shape Builder tool, which is a highly anticipated one, because Adobe Illustrator has done a while for this feature, and Inkscape finally managed to have it. And the way you do that is, we have this Shape Builder tool over here on the toolbar. We can have it, and you can really have it because you must select some object to use it. So I'm gonna select this object over here to add an object in the middle of it. So let me zoom in, and let me choose the Shape Builder tool over here. And if you want to add some object, we have two modes. The first one is the Add mode, and this one is Delete mode. Let's go to the Add mode. And I'm gonna make it blue in the middle like that. And if I click finish, we have our object over here. And it's gonna delete the other one because we are not adding the other one, and which means we subtracting the other one. So if you don't want that, let's get back to it and back to Shape Builder tool. And I'm gonna select this one, make it blue. And the other one, I'm gonna make it blue as well. And click finish. As you see, we retain some of the previous object. But at the same time, my friends, we have this new object over here. So for your one, I'm going to just delete that and retain this one. And I'm going to show you guys the delete features of the Shape Builder tool. So select all of your objects and just select the Shape Builder tool or press X on the keyboard for a shortcut. And see here, if we change to, if we choose the delete mode, we can have this magenta slash purple color. And it's gonna delete the next one, the object that we've selected, and just select this one, you know, left clicking it and just drag it to delete everything. I'm gonna select this one in the middle as well. I'm gonna click on that, and it's gonna delete everything. So let's click finish, and we have these two objects over here that created from the Shape Build tool. Matter of seconds with Shape Build tool, highly efficient. The next one is the Lasso Selection for nodes. You'll appreciate this feature because it's gonna draw and or selecting a node by drawing it, especially when you have so many nodes in tag. As you guys can see here, we have so many nodes, and we can use the rectangle selection, but it's not highly efficient and not very flexible. So the way you do that to use the Lasso Selection tools is hold Alt and just drag it like this, and surround it with the red lines. As you see, we select that. I'm gonna hold Shift and Alt and select this one again, and it's highly flexible and efficient. So the next feature is the new parents and parent editors. Not only do you have access to a funky and practical library of parents within Inkscape, there's a new parent editor that enables you to adjust the parents. So let's select this object over here and go to Object and Fill and Stroke, and I'm gonna change the fill from the flat color into the parent. And within the parent, we have some parent over here. We can have the halftones, the grids, and everything. I'm gonna choose the halftones one, and we can change the color itself from here, the new editor, make it red like this. And I'm gonna choose this one that says edit on canvas, and if you click on that, we have this rectangle over here that's represent the scale X, scale Y orientation. It's basically just representing everything on the editor itself. So we can edit on the canvas over here. It's for scaling. If I hold control, as you see, I'm gonna lock the proportions and have retain the proportions and make it look even better. And we have this one over here. It's gonna move the parent alongside within our shape. And for this one, the circle one, it's gonna rotate the parent within the object itself. And this thing is really useful, especially you want to create some parents within minutes. And the next one, you have the complete control over margins in Inkscape. You can edit the margins within the canvas itself. We have this our page over here, and if you go to the edit page, we have these handles over here, and we have these round handles over here that if we add some numbers in this margin control bar, page margins, as you see, we have the new margins going on. So if I add more, like 50. As you can see, the old margin is gonna be 50 pixels. And if you click on this icon over here, we have this flyout that says 50, 50, 50. And you can change everything, you know, as you can see on the right hand side. I can make it into 100, and it's gonna be 100 pixels, and as well as the patch bleed if you want to. And if I select and drag on the circle nodes, as you see, I can have the margins, and the margins is gonna follow up with the nodes, so we can edit the margin however we want. And the margins, it's gonna be snappable, so if you snap it over here, let's duplicate this thing and snap it over here, it's gonna, you know, snap around and make your canvas even better. So the last thing is the paint color and the color palette in Inkscape. So Inkscape, they're for working hard for us, the designers, to find the colors so we can succeed on our project. As you guys can see here, we have just the normal color palette. And if you right click on that, we can set fill, set stroke, and this new one, paint color. And you have this big color palette, which is the pin one, and we can do that with the rest of the color, so you can see. And if we don't want that, we can just right click on the big color palette and unpin it, this one again, and just unpin it so it's returned back to normal. So that's the new feature on Inkscape 1.3. I can cover more if you want to, maybe next time if I get the chance. Let me know what's your favorite, and as always, thank you for your time.